Hi, welcome to MyGayToronto.com. My name is Sean Lieber. In focus, my guest today is Toronto DJ Cesar. Welcome.
Thank you. Thank you. Very good. Thank you for having me here.
Okay. And when it comes to the music, how was your music involvement? How did everything start?
I think it started back in the 90s when I was traveling around and going to the circuit. And at first, when I, in 1994, when I started go dancing in Montreal, Cox, for one full year, and I used to go to a DJ booth all the time and hang out with the DJ, with the Stephen Wallace, and I felt, you know, I was fascinated with it. Then I started doing the circuit, and I find out, you know, all the sounds, and I thought that I could bring a little bit of my Cuban flavor into the music, and that's how I you know, everything started, thinking that I could bring that, a little bit of that flavor. And the first thing that I did was I was playing the leather party with Peter Hofer, with the late Peter Hofer, and I did a track called Leather Fucker, a 30-minute long track for a show that it was gonna be the ending of my set towards Peter. They told me, we're gonna have a show at the Cool House. And I recorded everything. I did the vocals, everything, and I did the whole entire piece so that when the S&M show was happening, it wouldn't be happening on different type of music. So it all worked out really well.
You're well known for your sexy, dirty sexy beats. You're a resident DJ at
Steamworks.
But what I also find it's very interesting when you usually, you guess it a lot in South America. When you do your international guesting appearances, you kind of go a little bit opposite. So I find it really interesting, two different styles.
Yes. Yeah. Well, you know, that's the beauty. Also, outdoor gigs are different too. The Steamworks is a more darker, edgier, after hour sound with a lot less vocals, while the outdoors events, for example, they have a more easy to dance flavor, happy. No one wants to play dark stuff outside. I don't want drama. I'm very picky with the music I play outside, because it's more like you play with the emotions of people, and when everybody's outside, you want to make them to feel good, to be happy, and not to think about problems or their drama. So I'm very picky and not only choose the groove, but the type of vocals that, you know, it's a long process that goes into it for me.
Great. So Pride is almost upon us. The first time ever Pride Month, I was just like one week away from a Pride. You've been involved in a Pride over many, many years as a DJ and guesting. Is that the case for this year? Can we see you over stage? When we can see you, what's happening?
Well, this year, it seems like they are changing the direction. Okay. That's what I heard, that, you know. And usually the process runs through an application process. It's been happening for many, many years. You would apply with the bio and the music. Okay. And your pictures and your intent to participate. This year they eliminated that process, and it drastically reduced the amount of established local DJ, the ones who have participated on those stages for many, many years, the ones who are playing the club on a regular basis, are not represented with a section or one or two. The ones who, on a yearly basis, they have played those stages, and people come back to return to the stages to hear them play, they are not playing. I cannot really tell you who all the DJs are. I have not heard the names of many of those. I really don't know how the choosing process of those DJs came out.
It sounds a little bit disappointing considering that it's first time ever Pride Month, but it wasn't found a little bit space for everybody, for different generations, different type of DJs.
Absolutely.
Established. So saying that, is there anything else we can see then at this Pride or?
On June 25th, I'm going to be playing Sin, which I have a residency with them at the Eagle.
Okay.
That's going to be at the Eagle. It's a fun party to spin, and if you've ever been to it, it's a lot of fun. Then on the following Saturday, on the Saturday of the Pride, at 7 p.m. at Club 120, I'm going to be playing for Toronto Naked Men.
Okay.
A party. It's going to be very interesting. I've never played a party where everybody's going to be naked. I am not going to be naked, but they will be naked. Okay, maybe I'm going to be in a swimsuit.
Okay.
You know, but I don't want to distract myself from it.
Okay.
Besides, it's their party. I'm going to be working. They're going to be having fun. I'm going to be working. And every day of I'm going to be playing a 6-hour set at Steamworks every single day, starting Thursday until Monday night. So it doesn't mean that I will be working at nighttime all the time at Steamworks, but I will definitely be playing 6 hours daily. So basically, I will probably will not miss you, not see me anywhere else.
Okay.
Because I'm very, you know, I like to sleep and I like to eat and I like to chill and I like to give rest to my ears, and I definitely don't like to be drinking if I'm going to be working.
Thanks again for your time and for coming over once again for My Gay Toronto, Sean Lieber. Thank you for watching.
Thank you very much for having me. That was awesome.
Thank you.